to get deep vision of Immortals jungle. So advantage Immortals.
Yep, 5,000 gold is the lead. Rain over his inside, rushes jungle again, taking down the wolves, looking high in the face and saying, yeah, I dare you. Hi, flash into the headbutt, into the damage. The stuns come through, and whoa, Rainover can't quite die. But the re-engage sure comes through. Rush is low, so is high. A re-engage by Balls. Adrian taking plenty of damage. The push comes through for Sneaky. Here comes the curtain call. One onto Wild Turtle. Two on towards him. Now towards Rainover, and he gets him from downtown. Adrian goes down. That is the first kill of that fight. There's the javelin. There's the re-engage. C9 starting to win it though. Pobelter and Hootie both very low. Lands the Q. Will he go? Yes, he will. One more hit, he'll do it. Rush gets the kill, flashes out, and look at that. It's 3-2 in favor of Cloud9.
Even with the gold disadvantage, Cloud9 is willing to make a decisive call and go for it. It's always been what High has been willing to do as a shot caller, is try and take the game back. Do not let the other team give it to you, because they know Immortals will not do that. And oh my, the start on Rainover, you thought it was gonna turn terrible when they didn't finish off Rainover, but they persisted on that fight and continued to follow through. Watching this right here, Malphite is too far away to necessarily follow this up, and they actually get the chain stun from the W on Sneaky.
Yeah, the gravity
they don't get the stun. They maybe get the stun from the gravity field, but he backs away early. Jensen then holds his ultimate a little bit, which is good, because he waits until he can get it on the biggest group possible and waits for the Malphite ult to do so. Very good coordination there. And then the Jin ultimate pushes Turtle back, and then he's trying to kill Rainover with it, but Braum actually, does he get thrown out?
Fates call out
into the ult! Oh my god!
I will protect you. It wasn't going